This week we've got a blast from the past pistol. This is one of my personal favorites. This is a Browning 1955. If you recognize it, it's probably because you may have seen it marketed by FN as the FN Model 1910. This pistol dates back to that period, so this is a 109-year-old design. The 1955 was the version brought in beginning right about 1954 or 1955 by Browning Arms Company in St. Louis, and this gun is so marked. Really, the only differences between the guns are that this one says Browning here on the stocks, and the FN has the FN logo in that area. This particular gun has a 3.5-inch barrel. It's chambered in 380 ACP. I've set the magazine here, and six 380 ACP cartridges denote that it is a six-round magazine. It's a steel magazine. The gun has some of the classic European features in that it has a heel magazine release. It also has a pivoting grip safety, but it's different than the 1911 in the sense that it's pinned and pivoting at the bottom. So when the web of the hand comes in to grasp the gun, it deactivates by moving inward at the top. The gun also has a manual safety, and that is also used for takedown of the gun. Now, and that's about it. You don't really, on this model, oddly, compared with the baby Browning, which is sort of the junior version to this in 25 ACP, you don't get the cocked indicator or any other controls on this gun. You just have the mag release and the manual safety. Now, what's interesting is that this was one of the first guns to use the fixed barrel as a place to wrap the recoil spring around. So when this gun fires, the barrel stays in position in the frame. The barrel is actually removed from the frame for takedown by rotating it because there's a bushing at the end that's knurled. It comes out, and then the barrel is rotated and lugs engage the frame. And as you rotate it, they disengage and you're able to pull the barrel off. But the barrel itself acts as a guide rod for the recoil spring. It's a striker-fired gun, and like I say, for some weird reason, Browning decided not to integrate the rear of the striker assembly to indicate that the gun is cocked on this model, even though he did on the baby Browning. John Browning himself is said to have carried one of these guns in his pocket as a personal protection firearm. As we can see, this gun goes back to 1955 and its grandfather goes back to 1910. A target version of this was made and imported after the GCA 1968 went into effect because this gun became illegal to import because of its size. It just didn't make the points. The target version of this had a 1-inch longer barrel, 4.5 inches versus 3.5 inches, and it had adjustable sights and it had pinky extension on the magazine. Kind of not really my favorite version, but a nice gun nonetheless. Not much in the way of sights on these guns, and despite the fact that the grip angle looks like it could be a little awkward, when you grasp this gun and point it, it really actually lines up properly. So once again, John Moses knew what he was doing. The Browning 1955. It's not made anymore, but Browning does make 380. So for more on those, visit Browning.com. For more guns of the week, visit AmericanRifleman.org.